What's up, people? Welcome to Interview with Abhimanyu. A quick message to the Indian Air Force, the Indian government, and the Prime Minister. Good job, we are proud of you. Now, my guest today is a bro of mine. He is a birder, a wildlife photographer, a traveler, and his PUBG username is Bhalu the Bear. This dude has immense knowledge about animals, birds, and their behavior. We had fun talking about wolves, tigers, pigeons, eagles, and also how one should take time to figure out what he or she needs to do in life. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the adventure seeker, the birding aficionado, Arjuna Chavan.
If God appears one day and tells you, Arjun, you've been a bad, bad boy, yeah, and I am going to put you on a deserted island for the rest of your life. But since I'm God, right, I'm magnanimous, I'm very dayalu. So I tell you that you can take one animal along. Choose one animal that you can keep for the rest of your life. Okay. No form of life ever, just one animal. Which animal will you choose?
I'll choose a cat.
A cat?
Yeah.
Bro, you won't believe, I had an interview with someone else. So this guest, we were talking about cats, and we were talking about how cats are big assholes. I mean, that's my opinion. That's really my opinion. I don't like cats. So, cats?
Actually, even I know that they are big assholes, but like, I've been, like, you know, born and brought up with cats all around me.
So your family always had cats?
Yes, we always had cats. And right now, for some reasons, we don't like keep them at home.
Okay.
So, to make up for that, I started keeping my cats at friends' places.
And they are willing to keep.
Yeah.
Because once a friend of mine told me that I'm going out, can you take care of my cat? I was like, no, ma'am. No, not going to happen. No.
And, in similar cases, what I do is then I try and keep them at my place for some time, like for 2 or 3 days. But yeah, I love cats. So
we are not talking favorite animal over here. Did you think deserted with a cat for the rest of your life? Are you sure about this?
Yes, because I know a lot about their behavior as well.
Okay.
I will know that even on a deserted island, the cat won't be totally dependent on me.
Uh-huh.
It will be independent. There will be moments that it will show me how useless I am.
Okay.
And how I need to, you know, stay focused and try to survive on this island.
Okay. You know what will I choose?
Yeah.
I'll choose a cow. It's not my favorite animal, but I'll choose a cow. Because tactical, bro. I mean, doodh, paneer, you know, everything. Yeah. And since God is giving me an option, I will give thoda sa dahi de do so that I can continue producing yogurt.
Right.
So, yeah, but I asked the same question to my friend once.
Hmm.
That, you know, she said, wolf. I was like, dude, I was like, you dumb woman. That wolf is going to rip you in shreds. But, yeah, wolf, people are fascinated by this. Do you believe in spirit animals? You know?
I think, yes, I do.
Yeah, so what's your spirit animal?
Again, I would say a cat.
A cat.
Yeah.
A cat. So, I've noticed one thing. You know, when people, there are Facebook updates. Okay, Miss XXX or Mr. Blah, blah, blah. So their spirit animal is tiger, lion. Have you noticed? Eagle, falcon, something, something.
Right.
Sometimes even mythological shit like, you know,
Dragons
and spirit animals. Kutta kisi ka nahi hota, kabhi note kiya hai? I mean, there are dog level. Like, Facebook and the internet is, you know, filled with, you know. Yeah, it's saturated with dog lovers and all. But koi bhi khud ko kutte se relate nahi karta. Have you ever noticed? No one says that, yeah, kutta mera wo hai. That I am a, you know what, Pomeranian or snappy Pomeranian or something. So, yeah, wolves, I mean, have you a little inclination? Because I think wolves are very ferocious. But somehow you tend to like them, right? You know that it's a wild animal, it will kill you. But you somehow have that, maybe because of, you know, Game of Thrones and stuff, whatever.
Nah,
they put them as, you know, whatever, some strong, beautiful, mystical creature. But, yeah, so have you ever, like, you know, were you ever inclined towards wolves or especially wolves?
So, looking, you know, at my background and what I like to do, I know a lot about wolves. I know about their behavior and everything.
Okay.
And so, right now, a lot of books and stories that we read, even the fiction ones, like Jesus mentioned, Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
So, they portray wolves, you know, like powerful.
Yeah, very powerful.
And attractive and close to human beings in many cases.
Yes.
And right now, like, if you talk about evolution, So the dogs that we have,
yeah,
all of them have one common ancestor.
That is the wolves. That is wolves.
So
okay.
Wolves, like human beings, in earlier times, they had, domesticated wolves. That is how we have dogs right now.
So they were, we had domesticated wolves.
Yes.
How is that possible? Wolves can't be domesticated.
Yes, yes. We tamed wolves during that time. And then,
weren't they huskies or something? I mean, I have just seen movies and also they look like wolves.
So that will, depending on the place that they were, but because human civilization, it was just not just at one place.
Right.
And there were always wolves around.
Uh-huh.
And so initially it was like a symbiotic relationship.
Okay.
Both of them helping each other out for safety, food.
Hmm.
And that is how this relationship developed between man and animal, especially wolves. Right.
No, I didn't know about that. I used to do it because it sounds very weird. Anyway, enough of that. Let's talk about your job, bro. Talk about your job. Yeah, I mean, I want to know that. How did you reach to this point? From I don't know what the fuck to do with my life. Like, yeah, where did it all start? Because it's really fascinating what you do right now. I want to know about it.
Exactly. So to be honest, during my earlier days,
born and brought up in Pune.
Yes.
In Pune.
Born and brought up in Pune.
Okay.
But even till my graduation, I was very confused about what exactly I want to do in my
life. That's new. Oh, I've never heard that story before.
I was very confused, and it was so basically like, hello, computers mein future hai, engineering mein future hai, medical mein future hai. So, waisi type ki soch thi. इसलिए ग्रेजुएशन भी कंप्यूटर
सब्जेक्ट्स साइंस थे या
नहीं कॉमर्स था
बट
इसके बाद भी तो आगे जाके क्या करना है कंप्यूटर्स
हाँ.
आज जमाने मतलब बहुत चल रहे हैं
right.
कुछ तो कर लेंगे कंप्यूटर्स के इस फील्ड में पैसा कमाने मिलेगा बट लोग
right.
पहले वही सोच रहे थे
राइट
ग्रेजुएशन कर लिया मास्टर्स भी कर लिया अगेन रैंडम
ये सब किसमें कंप्यूटर्स में हो रहा था
हाँ सो मास्टर्स कंप्यूटर्स में करना चाहता था एडमिशन भी मिल गई थी एक हफ्ता कॉलेज गया समझ में आ गया कि ये नहीं कर सकता
एंड व्हाट लाइन ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग
सो मास्टर बैचलर्स इन कंप्यूटर एप्लीकेशंस
ओके
सो जस्ट बेसिक कंप्यूटर लैंग्वेजेस एंड स्टफ
राइट
एंड मास्टर्स इन कंप्यूटर एप्लीकेशंस एज वेल सो आई डिड दिस फॉर 1 वीक But realized that I did not want to do that.
Okay. I have no idea. When you say Master's in Computer Application and all this stuff, so when you graduate and then you finally get a job, let's say you get a job, right?
Yeah.
So what are you doing? You're making apps and all? I have no idea when it
comes
to that. You're making apps.
Yes, similar.
So how different is that from a coder or a,
it is not
developer?
Very different because you learn about different types of languages that are used on different platforms.
Okay.
So these languages are used for coding.
Okay.
And coding is required for all online platform, be it apps, games, websites, like computer systems for companies.
So you learned all this and did you get a job? Did you apply and get a job?
I did not. So after graduation, as I told you, I did not continue my MCA.
Yeah, exactly.
But I need to, needed to have something to complement my bachelor's degree.
Okay.
And the best thing was the master's degree, an MBA.
All right.
बिकॉज फिर तभी सोच पड़ी कि चलो बी सी ए तो किया है अभी इसको कॉम्प्लीमेंट करके कोई अगर डिग्री मिल जाती है अगेन सो देन आफ्टर दैट आई कैन यू नो लुक फॉर अ जॉब सो दिस वॉज एम बी ए इन ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट अगेन मेरा खुद का बहुत ज्यादा सोच नहीं था इसमें अ फ्रेंड ऑफ माइंड टोल्ड मी दैट दिस लुक्स लाइक गुड डिग्री एंड मतलब आई टी फर्म्स में भी इसका मतलब
सक्स मैन हाउ पीपल रन आफ्टर ईच अदर ये कर रहा है वो कर रहा है एनीवे
सो Like I went ahead with it. Human resource management में भी MBA किया. So it was good.
Okay.
It's not like it was completely bad. HR के करते वक्त मजा आया. There was academics में projects वगैरह बहुत रहते थे. Exposure बहुत ज़्यादा मिला.
Right.
Got to know a lot about the corporate life.
Okay.
And
everything. But I'm waiting for that but. Okay.
Yes, yes.
So when did you know that, wildlife is your calling? How did it, the point where you got to know that, okay, this is it?
So bachpan se hi, matlab, ek type ka exposure rehta hai, wo TV, TV bahut zyada influence karta hai.
Yeah.
Aajkal ke bachcho ko bhi. Fortunately, mujhko Discovery Channel, National Geographic, wo sab dekhne bahut pasand tha pehle se hi.
Okay.
And there were a lot of, serials during that time, jab par नेशनल पार्क के बारे में बताते थे, बहुत सारे एनिमल्स के बारे में, टाइगर्स लायंस के बारे में. बट माय नॉलेज टू अबाउट
टाइगर, वी हैव टू टॉक अबाउट टाइगर्स, बट लेट यू फिनिश यार.
सो माय नॉलेज ऑफ दैट वाज रिस्ट्रिक्टेड टू जस्ट द टीवी एंड व्हाट इज शोन ऑन द टीवी.
राइट.
द रियल एक्सपोजर आई गॉट फॉर दिस वाज मास्टर्स के वक्त. वी हैड अ फोटोग्राफी कॉम्पिटिशन एंड माई सीनियर्स had put photos that get clicked in national parks around India. So there was a photo of a tiger. This was from Ranthambore.
Okay.
There was another photo of a short toed snake eagle.
Short toed snake eagle. Yeah. Okay. Like how is it different from eagle? Because currently eagle is my favorite bird.
Yeah. So like it belongs to a different family.
Okay.
A short toed snake eagle, as the name describes, it has short toes.
Yeah.
And its primary diet is snakes.
Okay.
So short toed snake eagle.
Okay.
Snake eagles is completely a different.
That's lazy work. Okay. So there was a picture of
a tiger from Ranthambore.
Okay.
And this bird.
Okay.
And this, I wanted to ask my seniors, where did they actually find these animals?
Okay.
Because I found that very attractive.
Mm.
The only time I had seen these. मुझे पता नहीं था कि ये मतलब मुझे खुद से देखना है, मेरी आंखों से, तो मैं कहाँ देखूँ.
हाँ,
सो आई आस्क्ड देम कि ये क्या है, कैसा, मतलब.
हर एक का अपना इंडिविजुअल होता है. What kind of message, divine message you get, right? I have seen a lot of pictures, right? I was like, yeah, wow, fascinating, what an animal. I never had this thing in my mind that mujhe agar asli mein dekhna hai to main kahan pe jaunga. So yeah, interesting. Please go.
So they told me ke matlab India ke kafi sare national parks hai. They told me about Ranthambore.
Okay.
They told me about this bird. Mujhe bhi aapke jaise pata nahi tha ki short toed snake eagle.
Right.
Mere liye bas ek hi word tha, eagle.
Eagle.
Sab jo bhi pakshi aasman mein hote sab eagle hote hai. Aisa specific naam hote hai to pata nahi tha.
Right.
सो उससे इंटरेस्ट जनरेट हुआ. मैंने फिर खुद और जानकारी ली उनके पास से, और ज्यादा मतलब बातें पूछी कि फिर और कौन से नेशनल पार्क है, कहाँ कहाँ पर है, कौन से जानवर दिखते हैं वहाँ पे. बर्ड्स के बारे में पूछने लगा कि इतनी भी वैरायटी होती है क्या. एंड देन आई माई सेल्फ हैड पार्टिसिपेटेड इन दिस कॉम्पिटिशन. एंड व्हाट्स इंटरेस्टिंग इज दैट मेरा जो कैमरा है, मेरे पास फोटोज लेने की बहुत आदत थी मुझको. मेरे नए घर का मतलब मैं जहाँ पे रहता हूँ अभी, तो बैकयार्ड में एक छोटा सा फॉरेस्ट है.
Alright.
और हमें मतलब बर्ड्स ऐसे ही दिख जाते थे मुझको.
Okay.
मतलब इतने सारे ट्रीज हैं, तो मैं आई यूज टू स्पेंड अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम इन माय गैलरी घर.
राइट.
एंड आई यूज टू हैव माय कैमरा विद मी. सो मैं जस्ट रैंडमली कोई बर्ड दिख गया तो मैं वो फोटो क्लिक कर देता था. और मेरे घर पे कैट्स थे तभी, तो मैं वो कैट्स के भी फोटोज क्लिक कर देता था.
Okay.
तो मैंने ये घरेलू बिल्ली और एक पक्षी का फोटो कॉम्पिटिशन में डाला था. देन दे हैड ऑल्सो आस्क्ड मी कि ये बर्ड तूने कहां पे देखा. So I told them कि मेरे backyard में देखा. So this was a bird, बहुत sparrow के size का bird था ये. And I thought till that time that it was a house sparrow. हम लोग जो चिड़िया बोलते हैं.
हाँ चिड़िया बोलते हैं.
These guys told me that it is not a sparrow.
It is a migratory bird.
Yeah, it is a migratory bird which you get to see during the winters.
Okay.
It migrates from
Eurasia. And it was called?
A greenish warbler.
A greenish warbler.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I was surprised. I did not know what it was, but that spiked my interest again. कि ये bird मैंने देखा, मुझे पता नहीं था. But now I know what it is.
Right.
And now I wanted to know more about it.
हाँ.
And that's how it all started actually. For
so
me.
That's how the it got ignited your interest. But how did you end up in, what's your company called?
Where
you
So I work at Foliage Outdoors.
Foliage Outdoors.
Yeah.
They arrange camping.
Right. They are a travel and tourism company.
Right.
So Foliage Outdoors is the sister company of Infinite Journeys. We are Infinite Journeys Private Limited.
Right.
So what Infinite Journeys does is they conduct customized trips for people.
Right.
It is like a tailor-made trip. You just go and tell them where you want to go, for how many days, and what you want to do.
Okay.
And they'll make a trip for you according to how you want.
So how did you end up in this firm, like this company? Like you were clicking pictures of Billy and Parinde and running competitions. Like how?
So these seniors that I was talking to, so I told them, so mujhe jana hai abhi kisi national park. Where should I go? And which ऐसी कौन सी जगह है जहाँ पर मुझे बहुत ज़्यादा birds भी देखने मिलेंगे?
अच्छा.
Not just the tiger.
Okay.
So I was suggested Corbett, Jim Corbett National Park. हाँ. उन्होंने बोला कि तू यहाँ पर जा. If you get lucky, you will get to see the tiger. But if not the
okay, I'll have to cut you off.
Yeah.
So we went to Jim Corbett.
Yeah.
because everyone goes to Jim Corbett to see tiger, right? Yeah. Of course, not birds, because Jim Corbett National Park, everyone wants to see a tiger, right? So there were 9 or 10 gypsies, right? Open gypsies, so they take the whole group, right? So, मैं और मेरे साथ मेरे दो bros, हम जा रहे हैं, और हमारा जो guide था ना, he apparently वो वहाँ का वो था, like he was the one to sit with, right? So he will, you know, give you, yeah, he knows where, he knows how to spot a tiger, or he knows how to find one, right? So हमें लेके गया, and he was very verbal about it, और उसके साथ उसका एक assistant भी होता है, driver, one assistant and one main guy, and rest of the people they're sitting पीछे, right? So, आपको क्या टाइगर क्या हम हाथी की सलामी दिलवा देंगे हाथी खड़ा करके दिखवा देंगे ऐसा एंड ही सेड एंड वी वर लाइक डूड यही आज से टाइगर दिखाएगा आई डोंट नो 3 hours 4 hours व्हाट एवरी अदर जिप्सी सॉ टाइगर एवरी अदर जिप्सी एवरी देयर वर 9 कार्स 8 ऑफ देम सॉ वन एसहोल इवन सेड लाइक वी वर सो यू क्रॉस पाथ्स प्रीटी ऑफन व्हेन यू आर इन कॉर्बेट राइट मेनी जिप्सी वो दिखा दिखा पूछते हैं एक दूसरे से कहां देखा वहां गया So, यहाँ पे वो बड़ा खुश होकर एक फैमिली आ रही है तो उसमें से एक अंकल जी उठे ऐसे दिखा हमने कहा नहीं कहते देखो हमने आधा घंटा टाइगर ही डिन से कि हमने 2 टाइगर देखे 1 देखा ही सर हमने आधा घंटा टाइगर देखा आई वाज लाइक यार सो आई वाजंट लकी आई हैव ऑलवेज सीन अ टाइगर इनसाइड अ केज और यू नो अ ज़ू ओपन जो अपना एरिया में रखते हैं दैट्स इट सो या वो सो यू वेंट टू जिम कॉर्बेट
यस सो दे सजेस्टेड जिम कॉर्बेट एंड द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन आई डिड नॉट नो किसके साथ नो कि किसके साथ जाना है मतलब मुझे नहीं पता था कि ऐसे ट्रिप्स कंडक्ट कौन करता है देन दे टोल्ड मी अबाउट फुलेज आउटडोर्स कि द बेस्ट पीपल टू गो विथ वुड बी फुलेज आउटडोर्स दे हैव रियली नॉलेजेबल पीपल हु नो द प्लेस एंड हु
सो इनिशियली यू जस्ट अप्रोच दिस कंपनी फॉर एज अ कस्टमर लाइक एज अ कस्टमर
फॉर अ कैंप And did that right after my master's ka final exam.
Right.
Maybe 2 days later, I had gone for this camp.
Okay.
To Corbett. And so we were talking about tigers and how it is all about luck. See,
yeah.
Basically, matlab park mein wo jo guides hote hain, jaise aapne bataya, wo roz jaate hain almost. So last day, jo movement thi na tiger thi, kaun se area mein thi, wo unko pata hoti hai. And depending on that, wo wale zone mein koi jagah choose karte hai ki humne yahan par jaakar rukna chahiye.
Pani peene aata hai.
Because last time yahan par dekha tha, maybe bachche hai saath mein, isliye isi area mein ghum raha
hai.
Kisi tiger ki territory hai, to ye area chhod kar jaata hai. Depending on that. So, ये कोशिश रहती है हमेशा because tracks, signs, sounds, इससे ही हम लोग लोकेट कर सकते हैं प्रेडेटर को एंड एट द एंड ऑफ इतना सब कुछ करने के बाद इट इज जस्ट शेयर डम लक लाइक इफ यू गेट टू सी इट और नॉट सो मैं गया कॉर्बेट पे मेरा एम था मतलब बर्ड्स देखना है बहुत सारे
right.
सर आप पता चला है कि इतनी वैरायटी होती है बर्ड्स में इतने सारे बर्ड्स देखते हैं इंडिया में भी एंड इट स्टार्टेड ऑफ रियली वेल मेरा पहला राइड हमारा गुजरानी में था
okay.
एक प्राइम जोन है कॉर्बेट नेशनल पार्क right. में और स्टार्ट किया बहुत बर्ड से ही बर्डिंग से ही स्टार्ट किया बहुत सारे बर्ड्स दिखे पहली बार मैंने ये पाइड किंगफिशर एक होता है
वाइट और ब्लैक कलर का होता है या आई सीन दैट
स्टॉर्क बिल्ड किंगफिशर होता है स्टॉर्क एक अलग ही बर्ड है किंगफिशर अलग बर्ड है पर इस किंगफिशर की जो बिल होती है वो एक स्टॉर्क के जैसी होती है इसके लिए इसका नाम स्टॉर्क बिल्ड किंगफिशर ऐसा है तो वो
व्हाट आई रियली लाइक अबाउट किंगफिशर इज मैंने सिर्फ उसी ट्रिप में देखा था उसी एरिया में काफी मिलते हैं व्हाट वाज द फर्स्ट वन
पाइड
Yeah, so I like the way it hovers over exactly, the water. It is amazing. It is very fascinating to, you know, जब वो हवा ऐसा लगता है कि पूरी body still है. It's just the wings.
Yeah, that are even
blurry.
Does
yeah,
and the way very interesting to observe that
yes, behavior. Yes,
just hovering in one place when it notices कि ठीक है, it's got its prey in its sight.
Right.
It just dives.
Right.
Goes in the water, catches the prey and comes out.
Yeah, the way it comes out. Yes, yes, I've seen that. I couldn't catch it. On a camera, yeah. but it was amazing. The sight was amazing.
Absolutely. Yeah, so the first ride started the right there with a lot of birding. And we came to a place, a grassland patch in Bijrani.
Okay.
Jahan par exactly, matlab logon ne bataya ki yahan par tiger ki movement hai.
Right.
Par grassland tha. और टाइगर का कैमोफ्लेज इतना अच्छा होता है कि जो समर वाले स्पेशली जो ग्रास होता है एग्जैक्टली टाइगर के कलर के जैसा होता है
right.
तो समझ में नहीं आता है कि बैठा भी है तो कहां पर बैठा है
आई सीन वीडियोस देयर लाइक व्हेन दे हाइड यू कांट सी देम सडनली ही जस्ट
सो द ग्रुप लीडर दैट वी हैड फ्रॉम फुलेज आउटडोर्स
राइट
लाइक ही हैड स्पॉटेड इट आई डोंट नो हाउ ही इज लाइक यू गाइस जस्ट नीड टू वेट यू आर लकी टाइगर यहां पर है इज जस्ट दैट वी नीड टू वेट फॉर इट टू स्टार्ट मूविंग
ओके
दैट इज व्हेन यू विल सी इट
राइट How do they get to know ki wo yahan hai? Because he must be hiding, right? So they must have seen what, pug marks or what? How do they get to know?
They get to know by calls. These are signs, pug marks and territories. Tigers have territories.
Okay.
So this is a specific area inside a park. They don't go out of that.
Okay.
Especially male tigers. They like to stick to their own territory.
Okay.
This territory can be around 80 to 100 kilometers long.
Okay.
So that is huge.
Yeah, that is huge for us. Yeah.
Exactly. So और मैं हमारे जो गाइड थे वो मतलब he's an expert. He's been he had been in this field for almost 15-16 years.
Okay.
So he could locate the place where the tiger was sitting. हम लोग 10 बार भी देख के हमको समझ में नहीं आ रहा है वहाँ पर कि tiger बैठा है वहाँ पर. Until the moment this tiger got up and started walking.
Okay.
Then we realized that there's a tiger sitting over there.
Right.
And we've been there all along. और हमें समझ में नहीं आया.
So
this was a brilliant moment. Like for me, I was not expecting to see a tiger, but still in the first wildlife safari of my life.
Was it a life-changing experience?
So yes.
Yeah, definitely. Tiger? Yeah, fascinating.
I was shaking at that moment. It is a big cat.
It's very, very scary, big, intimidating. Have you ever encountered, so when you go to places like Jim Corbett and all, so they tell you stories about man-eaters as well, right? Man-eaters. And what's really cool is that they name the tiger, the man-eater, after the person who the tiger has killed. Like one person was called something. Well, let's just say Arjuna or Abhimanyu. Yeah? So the tiger is called Arjuna because that man-eater killed a guy from the department. Or someone, you know, do you call them rangers or whatever? The people who are taking care of the area, right? So they often get killed over there. Mm-hmm. So if there's a man-eater on loose, they will attack someone who's alone and something else. So they name the man-eater after the man they've killed, right? So I'll tell you something really fascinating. So my friend's grandfather, he owns this farm, a big place in near Ramganga, Uttarakhand, right? Near Jim Corbett. It's quite close. So he received an article from a friend. So have you heard about this magazine called Outdoor Life? It's very famous, right? Outdoor Life. So this article was published in 1966.
Okay.
1966 by some guy called, I don't know how to say the first name, but his second name is Turner.
That's
Turner, right? Some Turner, right? So he wrote about man-eaters in Nainital.
Right.
And there were a few, I read the whole article. It was very fascinating. So when a man-eater attacks a man, right?
Yeah.
So first, he will start with your thighs or your butt. So he has killed you, right? He has killed you. So now you're just lying dead. So he will start eating your thighs, the fleshy part, right? He'll start eating your thighs and then your butt, and then he'll go to the viscera and everything else, right? So they said that, do you know how man-eaters are, like how does a tiger turn into a man-eater?
Okay, so
I'll let you say because I'm going to share something really important that not important but very fascinating that I found in that article. So people used to carry guns, right? People used to carry guns, and these were old muzzle loading guns. So do you know anything about guns?
A little bit, because of PUBG.
PUBG is all modern warfare weapons, right? So these muzzle loading weapons. They are very old, dated weapons.
Mm-hmm.
And हमारे जम्मू में उनको कच्ची rifle बोलते हैं.
अच्छा.
For a reason, because mostly you put bullets inside a gun, right?
हाँ.
So these were loaded from the barrel.
Barrel loaded.
जो पुराने muskets जैसे पुरानी movies में देखे. So they put pellets and they put gunpowder, जिसको पहाड़ों में लोग बड़ी बार दारू भी बोलते हैं, you know, बारूद जिसको बोलते हैं. And then they ram it inside and then they kill.
हाँ.
So these were old, dated weapons, and they used to the pellets, the buckshot, whatever it was, right? Whatever there is inside the weapon, it spreads, right?
Hmm.
So most of the times it doesn't kill the tiger. So the tiger is wounded, and hence the tiger, you know, I don't know. Obviously, he's still alive, but he's wounded, like his whatever. Spirit. So he turns against humans, and then he only preys on humans.
Okay.
Only.
So I tell you, बहुत ज़्यादा misunderstandings होती है.
Okay.
Tigers के बारे में, especially man-eaters के बारे में.
Right.
The primary reasons when a predator turns man-eater,
okay,
is because first of all because of old age. Old age में when they are not able to hunt for themselves.
Huh.
So they look man for
is an easy prey. Okay.
Easy prey. Obviously. Man is an easy prey.
Even a baby cub tiger can kill a man easily. Not like this small, but yeah.
the cattle jo hota hai, gaay, bakri wagere, they are easy prey.
Okay.
Kabhi kabhi kutte bhi.
Okay.
So old age is one thing. Another
right.
thing is injuries.
Right.
Injuries ke wajah se bhi tigers kabhi kabhi hunt nahi kar pate.
That's really fast. That's a side that I never considered.
So stealth is one important tactic that
for
the tiger
hunting,
uses. But even for stealth,
right.
you have to move quietly like a ninja.
Yeah.
But if you're injured,
like a ninja,
you
like the way you said, ninja.
Move properly, then you're not able to catch your prey. You won't be able
so
to
that's
eat.
Why you're hunting humans.
Yeah.
And people say that because the tiger was full of
yes.
revenge or something.
So
that's... So
see, what you said, ki, they get injured. So
right.
that can be one way.
One of the reasons.
Injury,
yeah.
That they've turned man-eater.
Right.
And so what happens is once also they've got the taste of the flesh.
Okay.
And that can
Must
be
delicious.
Yeah. That can be a factor that leads to, you know... telling the tiger themselves ki now this is easy prey, I
right.
can get it like, you know, aasani se mil ja sakta hai aur kha bhi sakta hu.
Right.
So,
yeah, that
like
makes sense. That makes sense. You just opened something new in my brain right now. And
jo fir chote tigers bhi hote, if the mother tiger is injured or not
right.
able to hunt properly for herself,
so she,
if she starts killing humans and
right.
starts feeding humans to the
cubs, yeah.
then they'll get habituated to the same meat, right? So that is how this all happens.
And
it's just a big misunderstanding. We always understand ki, so for that human being, it is a big loss.
Okay.
And this is where also human animal.
Yeah, a lot of people are getting killed because of
conflict,
these tigers. Yeah.
Comes up when a person from my family got killed because of a tiger.
Right.
Revenge ka hi aa jata hai na dimag.
Right.
And then
movie bhi aayi thi na Kal, ab uski. That was total bullshit. Not that Kal.
So basically, they are just misunderstood.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. So but have some Oreos, bro.
Yeah. Sure.
And there's some homemade peanut butter as well, if you want.
Wow.
So, bird.
Hmm.
Anything fascinating that you've learned about any bird? Because I really want to talk about pigeons after you finish. I have something to share about pigeons. I have to let it out. I mean, yeah. But in your experience.
See, what's fascinating for me is that in like just in India,
hmm.
or if you talk about the Indian subcontinent,
hmm.
There are around about 1300 different species of birds.
1300, okay.
That you can see.
Hmm.
And this number...
Not the ones that migrate from outside, like our
no, this
indigenous
is,
up in India.
Is counting the migratory species
okay.
as well.
Okay, okay.
But some of the birds that you get to see in this region, irrespective of the season. So
when you say this
migrate,
region, as in Western Ghats, Maharashtra, or just...
India.
India,
in
okay.
general, yeah.
Okay.
But yes, as you say, so there are resident birds, there are migratory birds,
hmm.
there are endemic birds.
Okay.
So endemic is the word where that I can use
okay.
to tell you that this bird can only be seen in this region
right.
and nowhere else all over the world. So yes, so aise categories hote hai. But again, collectively, itne 1300 se zyada hai.
Right.
And that this number fascinates me because I want to have a look at all of them, observe where they are, what they do, and get to know more about them.
Okay.
And this is what leads me to travel as well. It tells me to travel because koi ek bird hai jo main mere ghar ke paas nahi dekh
sakta.
I have to travel to go to the place to see where it actually stays.
Right.
Desert National Park ek jagah hai, Viran Banjar jagah.
Okay.
Desert hai pura.
Right.
बट वहाँ पर भी इतने सारे बर्ड्स दिखते हैं अलग अलग टाइप के, ये किसी को पता है पता नहीं है. लिटिल रन ऑफ कच्छ क्या है, इट इज जस्ट प्लेन, बट दिस प्लेस हैज लाइफ, सो मच लाइफ.
रन ऑफ कच्छ
बी सरप्राइज्ड टू
सी. एंड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ लाइफ आर वी टॉकिंग अबाउट, लाइक एनिमल्स, बर्ड्स?
एनिमल्स, बर्ड्स, बोथ. सो रन ऑफ कच्छ इज मेनली नोन फॉर द वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी. वाइल्ड लाइफ इज animal endemic to that region.
Right.
The only other wildlife that is found in India is in the upper regions. So
what's the word that you're using? Wild what?
The wild ass.
Wild?
Wild ass.
Wild ass.
Yeah.
Wild ass.
Yeah.
Matlab gada.
Haan.
Khota jisko bolte hain. So wild khota. Oh, nice.
So it is found in the Little Run of Kutch.
And how? Let's just Google wild ass.
Yeah.
Yeah. So how is it different from a regular...
how do I say
so that? It's endemic, the word you use,
yes,
endemic
yes, yes.
to, that's how you use the word, so endemic to run of Kutch,
yes.
that animal, okay. I don't know whether I used it correctly, but yeah, I got the idea.
To, okay. Only found in that region and not
wild ass. Google will surely give something else. Indian wild ass. Oh, yeah. Yeah. The legs are more like a zebra. It has stripes. Okay. Found in Run of Kutch only.
Hmm.
Okay. And yeah, birds. So we were talking birds, yeah.
So again, अलग अलग जगह है जहाँ पर अलग 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 टाइप के बर्ड्स दिखते हैं. I'm also maintaining a list of the birds that I've seen.
Okay.
Some of them that I've photographed.
Right.
So
I've seen your account, bro. Instagram account. Yeah, it's fascinating, bro. It looks like ऐसे विश्वास नहीं है तो आपने किसी दोस्त ने किया तो ऐसा लगता नहीं कॉपी पे कहीं से Google but it's amazing, good stuff, bro.
So yes, right now I can proudly say that out of the 1300 plus bird species that are there,
right,
I have seen 500 plus.
That is amazing.
That makes me happy. That makes me want to continue to travel.
Okay.
To visit places.
Right.
And so it's not just birds that you get to see. You get to see new places. You get to meet new people.
Right.
You get to know new cultures because right. India, you know India. बहुत अलग अलग टाइप के कल्चर्स देखने को मिलते हैं सब जगह
पे. It is really fascinating that you know I'm it's a guess that every guy, every person must have seen at least. Let's not talk about people who have always lived in places like you know these concrete jungles like you know metropolitan cities. So they haven't. But people who are coming from you know hills or northeast or even the ghats, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm sure even they have seen at least 100, 200, maybe they have seen. No one keeps that in mind, right?
Exactly.
So I'm sure I have seen a lot in J&K, in Himachal. Absolutely. Yeah, but you said 500. You know those 500,
yes.
Right? Wow, okay, please, go ahead.
So, yes, as you said, like that's what motivates me to keep traveling.
Okay.
And that is how, you know, the Corbett experience.
Right.
That sparked the entire process for me.
For birds.
Yeah. Right. The need to know more, to gain knowledge,
okay.
To start traveling.
Huh. So, one thing, pigeons, yes. So, what's your take on pigeons? Like,
I don't like
pigeons. Yeah, thank God, thank God. That's amazing.
If it was upon me, if I was a part of a
pigeon. Be very careful with your words.
Team,
okay. Yeah.
I would, have falcons
right.
With me. And I would just...
I have a theory. I believe that pigeons shit a lot. I think they shit more than they need to shit, right? Just to piss us humans off. I'm not lying. There are pigeons everywhere. So I live on the 12th floor, right? So balcony, gallery, kabutar hai. And just to piss me off, I think they shit in front of me when I'm here. And it's like pigeon droppings everywhere. They are very resilient though, because you know, वो अपने वो twigs and all they start collecting just to make the ghonsla, right?
Yes.
I removed their the initial stage of the construction, right?
Mm-hmm.
Every single day for months, but after every 2 days that son of a fowl it comes back, that columbina whatever you call them, it comes back and it starts building its nest for 2-3 months continuously. I had to shut that place off. But he just didn't quit, He so very resilient. But I think they're dumb. Why? Because there's another place. So I put a net so that, they can't enter. They can't mess the place up. So there's this opening, like half a foot something like that. Yeah? There's this opening in the net. So I'm sure it got inside from that opening.
Mm-hmm.
Single pigeon, right? Stuck inside the balcony for, I don't know, I wanted the pigeon to leave, right? A, because he would shit the hell out of the area. Plus, I was feeling bad for the pigeon that he's going to die. Nothing to eat, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, whenever I try to, throw a towel or something, so I'll pick and throw him out or whatever. Obviously, he will fly up, down, whatever. But that dumb pigeon didn't get out for 3 or 4 days. There was just one opening. That's where he came in. Yeah, he didn't. Every morning when I woke up, he was like there flirting, trying to, just roam around. Look, I was like, you idiot. He came from that place, right? So, yeah, I hate pigeons. So I'm glad that I found someone who you actually, I respect you, bro, because you actually said that I want to unleash falcons on them. So that pigeon, I hope no pigeon lover, pigeon lover. My father had, so Jammu mein and kahin badi jagahon pe. So ye not our generation, because we don't have time and space for that. But my father and many others, right? They used to, you know, they had flocks of pigeons. And it was, you know, एक बड़ा वो होता था मोहल्ले में आपकी बड़ी पहचान होती थी कि इसके फ्लॉक में इतने कबूतर हैं दे यूज्ड टू कॉल देम कबूतर बाज इट्स अ फैक्ट यू नो दे वर नॉट जस्ट पेट्स दे वर केप्ट देयर टू यू नो टू फ्लॉन्ट सुप्रीमेसी ओवर अदर्स दैट आई हैड एंड देयर पर्पस वाज टू फ्लाई एंड लेट द नेबर्स अदर पीपल नो दैट माय पिजन्स आर रियली स्ट्रांग लुक एट देम फ्लाई एंड ऑल एंड दे यूज्ड टू कम बैक एंड यू नो रेस्ट इनसाइड द केज एंड शिट एवरीवेयर व्हाटएवर बट या पीपल रियली यूज्ड टू आई एम ग्लैड दैट यू डिडंट मैन दैट्स अमेजिंग सो या आई वांट टू टॉक अबाउट कैंपिंग लाइक व्हेन यू कैंप एंड ऑल सो यू अरेंज So, I mean, how does it, you know, connect? So you were a camper, you still are.
Yes,
right?
Yes.
You are into it, right?
Yes.
So now your job lets you do it for others, right?
Right.
So I want to know, said once you are going for a trek or whatever, how do you prep for it? So I know different places, so different, but there is one basic list, right?
Yeah.
So I've seen the pictures where your bike is, your panniers and all, everything is loaded, right?
Yeah.
So just for my information, like what do you keep every single time?
Right.
So, your gear, everything.
Yeah. Before that, I'll just tell you, you know, the age group or the people that we take along.
Okay.
Especially. So, we have kids camps.
Right.
Mostly the kids are going for the first time.
Right.
For camping.
Right.
वो लोग ज़्यादा attend करते हैं. Then we have wildlife camps. We have adventure camps.
Okay.
And then we have leisure treks.
Right.
So, and basically the young adults enjoy going to these leisure treks as well.
Right.
So your packing, what you want to take for this camp depends on the type of camp that you are going to. For example, kids camps ka bhi duration aa jata hai.
Right.
Kids camp ka duration kam hota hai. Kyunki bacche chote hai, pehli baar ja rahe hai. So,
और बच्चों को कैसी जगहों पे लेके जाते हैं?
हाँ, so kids camps के लिए these destinations are closer to Pune.
Pune, okay.
Because it is their first experience. So
plus आधे ऐसी wildlife sanctuaries ऐसी जगह पे लेके जाते हैं? नहीं,
so
लेके जाना चाहिए
ना? General know-how about the outdoors, about camping, about how it is to like be with other kids,
right.
Stay with them, to conduct and be involved in activities with them. वो पहला experience होता है बच्चों का.
Right.
इसलिए पुणे के आसपास की जगहों पे लेके जाते हैं वाइल्ड लाइफ एंड एडवेंचर कैंप्स आर कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट बिकॉज़ इसको जो एज ग्रुप आता है दे हैव ऑलरेडी बीन टू कैंप्स बिफोर दे हैव थोड़ा बहुत एक्सपीरियंस आउटडोर्स का सो एंड देन अगेन फॉर वाइल्ड लाइफ कैंप्स एडवेंचर कैंप्स ड्यूरेशन ज्यादा होता है उसके लिए व्हाट यू वांट टू पैक लाइक डिपेंड्स ऑन वेयर यू आर गोइंग समर्स में लाइक एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ के लिए सो जस्ट लाइट कलर्ड क्लोथ्स व्हिच वुड camouflage easily
with the terrain
then the equipment that you want to carry you can what is important is that you have binoculars
okay
you have a diary notebook you have a camera
right.
to record what you've seen
yeah
it should not be the priority to just go over there and click photos
okay
what happens today is bahut sare bacche udhar se badi badi lenses lekar jaate hain
yeah seen by left photographers
apne page pe upload karne ke liye
right
But that is not that should not be the priority.
Okay.
Yeah, people should go over there to know about the place, to know about the park that they are visiting. क्या वो इतना special क्यों है? वो किस तरह बाकी park से अलग है? वहाँ पे जो जानवर दिखते हैं वो बाकी park से अलग है या नहीं? वहाँ पे birds भी अलग दिखते हैं वहाँ दूसरे park से. Animals अलग हो गए. वहाँ पे tigers जो है वो अलग है obviously. वहाँ पर leopards भी दिखते हैं या नहीं? और वाइल्ड डॉग्स जो कैंडिड स्पीशीज होती है वो भी काफ़ी अलग होती है सो ये सब जानकारी होना भी इम्पोर्टेंट है जस्ट एंड नॉट जस्ट गोइंग ओवर एंड क्लिकिंग फोटोज सो या सो अबाउट द इक्विपमेंट दिस इज इम्पोर्टेंट जस्ट व्हाट यू नीड टू वेयर योर इक्विपमेंट बायनोकुलर्स कैमराज
एप्रोप्रिएट क्लोथ्स And anything, you know.
And apart from that, it is just the operational part.
And in terms of food or snacking, what do you carry if you're traveling? Nothing?
Not really. I don't carry much because I don't like to eat much when I travel.
Okay.
But still, dry snacks and biscuits, energy bars,
and
lots of water.
Yeah.
that is what I would like to.
Out of dehydration or anything.
Yeah. Adventure camps ke liye bhi, again, normally Himalayas mein hote hai. So, winter wear.
Right.
That
brings me to the travel part of your thing. So, out of all the places that you've traveled so far, one of the best that you really have up here, right? You know, yeah, wow, that was amazing. I know you love wildlife and all, but is there a place? Because I've seen your pictures of Ladakh. You know, I love that place somehow. That how was your experience in Ladakh?
It was like really good, unbelievable.
Yeah, I know many people, especially these Royal Enfield enthusiasts, right? Everyone goes to Ladakh, right? But you can't help it. It is so amazing. It just, you know, I think it is very intimidating, that place.
Exactly.
It is, right? Kashmir is beautiful. The second you cross Jawahar Tal, if you're going, you know, via road, if you're traveling. So, Jawahar Tunnel se pehle jo district aata hai, it's called Banihal. So the climate, the weather, everything, it's okay. Wo aap hill pe ho, wo thoda thanda hai, thoda sunny bhi hai, aisa bhi hai. But wo 2 kilometer ka tunnel through the hills, right? When you cross that, when you enter Kashmir, that's like when you enter Kashmir. The whole scene, it just turns into, you know, it's like 4K HD and it's beautiful, no doubt. I love Kashmir ka scenery. But Ladakh, alag janwar hai. Ladakh is intimidating, and it's like, you know, it's like the hills, they don't have trees or anything. It's just
barren
hills and roads, and it's just, I don't know. I thoda sahem jata hu wahan pe jaake. It's like a different experience. What was yours when you went to Ladakh?
I was coming to that. So Ladakh, Himalayas basically,
right?
Or mountains in general,
right?
Mountains, they have an attitude of their own.
I like the way you put it. Yeah.
And mountains like to tell you that you need to know your place.
Right. Yes. Yes. Absolutely.
And so you need to respect that fact.
Hmm.
आपने जो बताया अभी के सहम जाते हैं,
yeah,
वो होता है, वो सबके साथ होता है.
Exactly.
And that is where you get a new respect for nature.
Don't you think mountains. That's with every great landscape or area? Even if you go to a beach, so the vibe is different, I know.
Yeah.
But when you look at the sea, it is intimidating, right? मेरे दिमाग में तो कोई वो movies 2012 वाली आती, सुनामी आ गई है, मेरे दिमाग में यही आ रहा था जब मैं समुद्र को देखता हूँ, because it's huge, right? You're nothing.
Exactly.
So I think when it comes to nature, it is only beautiful for me, for others as well. When it's intimidating, when it scares you, right? It is beautiful. Otherwise, normal छोटे मोटे पहाड़ हाँ ठीक है, चढ़ गए, उतर गए, उतर गए. But yeah, please go ahead. So mountains. So,
yes, that was my experience, how it started. I was really looking forward to it.
Okay.
And hamara itinerary tha from Manali to Srinagar.
So you did Khardungla pass?
Yes.
Oh, nice.
We did Khardungla. Hum log,
sand dunes wala. Rotang. You went through Rotang. That's what I wanted to say.
Started off with Rotang.
Right.
Then after that, we stayed at Jaspa. Because that journey was lambi.
Yeah, it is.
We have to stay at Jaspa.
Right.
Jaspa se leke Leh tak fir, there's a long journey. An entire day. Aur usme, wo 5 high altitude passes aate hai.
Right.
So this journey can be tiring. Intimidating, but very beautiful.
Yeah.
Like if you're up for it, then it just takes your breath away.
So a friend of mine and I, we were driving, right? And you've been to Changla Pass?
Yes, yes.
That comes before the lake. What's
Pangong.
The Pangong Lake. So wo beach mein aata hai if you're going from Leh, right?
Yeah.
So it's in somewhere in the middle, right? And the Pahadi area, Kachi Road and all. So we had this safari, this friend's safari, right? And it was giving up on us, the car, right? So while away, like when we were returning, so it was getting dark, right? And we were scared because we had to rev this vehicle up a lot. Like, because I don't know, the engine was giving up or what. I don't know, but it wasn't climbing, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we had to rev it a lot, and like more than usual.
Yeah.
Oh, so we were a little scared, and that costs you a lot of fuel, right?
Uh-huh.
If you're revving a lot, right? So we came from Changla Pass to neutral. न्यूट्रल पे आए. कैन यू इमेजिन, लाइक फ्रॉम 17,000, इट्स ऑलमोस्ट 17,000 फीट, राइट? वहां से डर डर के और कहीं पहाड़ी में ना चले जाए, बिकॉज वी वॉन्टेड टू सेव फ्यूल, राइट? वी जस्ट डिडंट वॉन्ट कि वहां पे रात को पता नहीं कौन कौन स्नो लेपर्ड दिख जाए. आई डोंट नो क्या है वहां पे. And like with a dude, like stuck in a car with a dude, puri raat, nafi, yeah, not a good idea. We're like, yeah, let's just go. So yeah, please, again.
So that journey from Jaspa to Leh, very intimidating, but again, very beautiful. Leh itself, जो छोटा सा टाउन है फिर, जहाँ पे everyone you know goes to rest and just relax and just you know take in the altitude as well, get used to the altitude, because many people use it as a base to travel to the areas around. For example, आपको पैंगोंग जाना है, आपको खारदुंगला जाना है, आपको दीक्षित वगैरह वाला जो सैंड ड्यून्स वाला एरिया है, I am forgetting the name. Nubra Valley.
Yeah.
वहाँ पर जाना है. So Leh is mostly used as a base for that.
Right.
So Leh was again a completely different experience for us.
So other than Leh, what other place? Let's just talk one if you have to choose besides Leh. Leh is like everyone's favorite. Yeah. But yeah.
Apart from that, definitely Nubra Valley.
No. I'm talking like beyond that district or Himalayas. If anywhere in south or northeast or wherever.
Okay, like that. I'm not really sure because again mountains
yeah, something that, yeah. Even your t-shirt says mountain high. Okay, no need, it's all right. So bro, I think we've covered anything that you want to talk about, anything in your profession, whatever.
Now it's just that travel, you know, it's something that, you know, helps you discover yourself, helps you know who you are.
Right.
And that is what happened with me. Like I told you, initially I was not a very good mixer-upper. I was not very social.
Right.
Introvert tha.
Yeah.
Logo se baat nahi karta tha.
Right.
Zyada. Matlab apni dunya mein rehta tha.
But I want to know, when you were an introvert, did it hurt? Because I'm not an introvert. I do like minding my own business when I'm at public places. I'm not like, I'll go out of my way to talk to people, but I'm not an introvert. But when you know that you were an introvert, right? So, andar, does it hurt that why am I not able to talk to people?
No. So, when I think about it, it did not. Because I meri duniya mein rehta
tha. Khush tha. Okay.
It's just that travel helped me to, you know, dusre areas mein dekhne mein madad ki.
Right.
Logon se matlab ghulne milne mein, because logon se jab aap milte ho aapko alag alag unke experiences ke bare mein pata chalta hai.
Yeah.
And that you that helps you get a complete perspective about life.
Hmm.
Think about what you're doing and if it is right or wrong. Meeting people that can help with you with a lot of stuff. That is what I've found. And travel करके अलग अलग जगहों पर जाके लोगों से मिलके लोगों के अच्छे बुरी चीजों के बारे में जान के हमको पता चलता है ज़िंदगी के बारे में.
I'm really, you know, I'm happy in a way that you are actually following your dream, living your dream, what you really want to do. Because most of the people, they somehow, I'm sure, it's a bit personal, but I'm sure your job isn't giving you six figure salary or something like you. So, but still you're happy, right? You're happy.
Exactly.
And let's talk about 9-to-5. People are hating 9-to-5 nowadays, right?
Mm-hmm.
I don't blame them. Yeah, if you're going somewhere where you don't want to go.
Yeah.
But let's talk about this 9-to-5 thing. Everyone is like, I hate 9-to-5, fuck 9-to-5, whatever. This rut, whatever, rat race, whatever they call it, right? So, you are doing more than 9-to-5, I guess, when you're working, right?
Yeah.
I think sometimes it must be like, what, 6 to 12 midnight or
more
something.
More than that. So
yeah, more than that, right?
I tell you, I've been...
And you have a boss as well. You have a boss as well, right? So, yeah.
See, I've been through the 9 to 5 that you're talking about.
Right.
I know that experience. And I've now I'm in the travel industry. It does have its own, highs and lows.
Right.
But, and yes, as you said, you have to work overtime a lot of times.
Right.
But at the end of the day, when you go home, and you're still pumped up and ready to go back the next day.
Nice.
And do it all over again. That is when you know you're doing
that's
the right
a good
thing.
Feeling, man.
Yeah.
That's a good feeling.
When you're happy about what you're doing.
Yeah.
Because the initially jo 9-to-5 tha, main mere liye kuch nahi kar raha tha.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I know that there's always something new to look forward to.
And to learn. Yeah.
And to learn. And that is
I think one needs to figure his shit out, right?
Exactly.
Yeah. It doesn't matter what you're doing.
It is
alright
to take your time to figure your way, your path in life that you want to choose. It is okay to take your time to do that.
Sometimes I think if mujhe writing nahi mili hoti, yeah, this really, this new thing that I've started, mujhe agar ye nahi mila hota, I would have lost my mind. And then I think ki jo log nahi figure out kar pate hain ki what do they have to do, how do they have to, how to follow their dreams. If they don't know, it's like forcing yourself into something that you don't know, like, okay, this is cool, so let's do that. Sometimes I think that, I don't know, I think everyone who hasn't figured it out yet should, you know, अपने आप को अंदर दिमाग में बोलना चाहिए that okay, you should make a plan that okay, after 5 years I'm just saying, just lie to yourself. No, don't lie. Promise yourself. In fact, promise yourself that after 5-6 years, doesn't matter whether you have a family or a job or whatever you're doing. Just tell yourself that okay, I'm gonna leave everything. I'm gonna hit the road. Simple.
Yeah.
You don't have a plan. I'm gonna hit the road.
Exactly.
And I'll see what happens. But this is the plan. So I think I don't know whether you'll go to a, you know, after 5 years, whether you will go or whether you'll find your dream or whatever. But at least those 5 years, you will be a little less stressed. At least you'll tell yourself that I have a plan. I have a plan. And maybe, you know, God knows, you might figure your shit out, right?
Absolutely. And so this that you're talking about, that just hit the road.
Yeah.
This time that you give to yourself.
Right.
It's very important to try and think about what you're doing.
Right.
This time that you need to give, so that people these days are not able to give time for themselves.
Hmm.
And just living that mechanical life, which is the 9-to-5 life.
Can't even blame them, man. People have to earn. Yeah, I mean, everyone can't. It's very. It feels really, you know, bitter to say.
So there are sacrifices that you need to make. There are risks that you need to be ready to make.
Yeah, true.
Because if there's the choice, you want to earn a lot of money.
Right.
But you have a big bank balance, but are you happy with what you're doing? When you're coming home, when you look at yourself, are you happy? Or it's just that the next day.
Or you're dreading the next morning. Yeah, I don't want to do that. I don't want to do that. But you're still doing that. That's killing yourself way before dying.
Exactly. You get one life, so you need to think about what you're doing.
Yeah, that's awesome, man. I had a lot of fun talking to you. I hope I travel a lot of, you know, we see a lot of wildlife, because I think we will be the only generation who will see wildlife. Our grandchildren won't be able to. They'll read about it. They'll read about it.
Unfortunately, yes, that's what the scenario
is. Yeah. Arjun, I had fun, man. It was fun. I forgot. I have something. Usually, this show, interview, right, we have a policy that we receive gifts. But I have something really cool. I thought I had this, but I wasn't using this.
Oh, wow.
So, this is a paracord bracelet. You're already wearing one, but this has a compass.
Great.
A thermometer and a fishing line as well.
Oh, my God.
So, that's for you. I kabhi use nahi kar paya, because I don't go out anymore. Wow. Like, traveling, I don't go much.
This is awesome. I like it.
It has a blade, a fire starter, and that multi toolkit as well. If you open it, you'll get to know. That's awesome. For you.
This is something I can absolutely use.
That's for you, man. That's for you.
Thank you so much.
Cheers, man. Cheers.